And so, by dividing the weight and the girth of the penis by the angle or the, what do we call it again? The yaw of the shaft, what we finally get is the adjusted penis size, or TMI. Any questions so far? Yes, little girl over there.
What's a penis?
Oh, good question. The penis is the thing we're talking about that boys have that we're measuring. Okay, any other questions? Okay, so then let's move on to the example on your study sheet. How about you? Could you read the first example for the class? Example one, young lady, please read the problem out loud.
Example one. Randy has a penis that is 4.4 inches in length.
4.4 inches?
Its angle is 32 degrees. Its flaccid girth is 1 inch in diameter. His balls are 7 centimeters from the base.
7 centimeters?
Randy notes that the drift of his penis is 4 centimeters to penis right, and its dead weight is 0.5 kilograms.
Great, and so divide by the 17, carry the 1, and we can see that Randy's adjusted penis size, or TMI, is 6.3 inches. Do we got that? Randy's length is 4.4 inches, but his adjusted length is 6.3. So how does our example person, Randy, compare to others on the TMI scale? By referring again to the TMI chart, we see that a TMI of 6.3 is 0.8 inches more than the national average.
Okay, my name is Rebecca Ternod, and I'm an actual doctor of human sexuality and behavior. Unfortunately, you have been taught some very wrong ideas in the past couple of days, and I am here to set things straight.
Thank God.
I want you to try and forget these wild theories and understand that all that's important when it comes to a man and a woman making love is actually length times girth over angle of the shaft divided by mass over width.
Putain, mon terre!
We all want to.